श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम् श्रीमद्रामपदारविन्दमधुपः श्रीमध्ववंशाधिपः सच्छिष्योडुगणः श्रितजगद्गीर्वाणसत्पादपः अत्यर्थं मनसा कृताच्युतजपः पापान्धकारातपः श्रीमत्सद्गुरुराघवेन्द्रयतिराट् कुर्याध्रुवं मङ्गलम् सालङ्कारक काव्य नाटक कला कणाद पतञ्जल त्रय्यर्थ स्मृति जैमिनीय कविता संगीत परंगतः विप्र क्षत्र विडंग्री जात मुखरानेक प्रजा सेवितः श्रीमत् सद्गुरु राघवेन्द्र यतिराट कुर्याध्रुवं मंगलम् ॐ लौकिक वैदिक भेद भिन्न वर्णात्मक ध्वन्यात्मका अशेष शब्दार्थ ऋगादि सर्व वेदार्थ विष्णु मंत्रार्थ पुरुष सूक्तार्थ गायत्र्यर्थ वासुदेव द्वादशाक्षर मंत्रांतर्गत आद्य अष्टाक्षरार्थ श्रीमन्नारायण अष्टाक्षर मंत्रार्थ वासुदेव द्वादशाक्षर मंत्रांतर्गत अंत्य चतुरक्षरार्थ व्याहृत्यर्थ मातृका मंत्रार्थ प्रणवोपासकानां अस्मदादि गुरुणां श्रीमन्मध्वाचार्याणां अंतर्यामिन् हनुमदुपासित चरणः सीतापते श्रीरामचंद्रस्वामिन् नमस्ते 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 प्रणामस्तु ऑल सद्भक्तास I am a Kannada speaker, but I notice a lot of devotees here do not understand Kannada. Please raise your hand that do not understand Kannada. Yeah, there are quite a few. So I will make an attempt to speak in English so that devotees will understand. Before I would start my speech on Pratah Sankalpa Gadya, which is a masterpiece of Raghavendra Sripadangalavaru, I have a couple of announcements. Number one, as all of you are aware, as we are celebrating Raghavendra Swami Aradhana here, many in our motherland in India have been suffering, some because of drought, that is such an ironic thing, and some because of flooding. It is our duty of all devotees of Raghavendra Swami Guru to do our best, including praying to Sri Raghavendra Swami to help those that are in trouble in the flood, have lost homes, have lost devotees, have lost friends, relatives. Pray to Lord Raghavendra Swami to help them all. It is our duty. And forget about helping them financially. I'm sure you all do that. But making a phone call and asking them, is there anything we can do? Just a few words to comfort them. will go a long way. It is a highly meritful thing to do. So I request all of you to make that phone call to your friends, your relatives, to those who you consider Atmiya, ours, and do the best you can. And commit about that in the presence of Sri Aurobindo Swami. The second and the final announcement, because I'm here for something else. Somebody reminded me to clarify this question that is bothering or may be bothering some of the devotees. We performed Suvarna Kavacha Mahotsava for Raghavendra Yatigalu today. It is an auspicious moment. Not only that, for those who have participated, it is a historical moment in their life. They would cherish these moments all their life. It is such a wonderful, cherishable moment. Now, some doubt wanders here and there. He is a sannyasi, and we adorned him with Suvarna Kavacha. They have given up the ordinary clothes and they are wearing saffron, kavi. And for that sannyasi, we are putting Suvarna Kavacha. How appropriate is this? That is the question some may have in their mind. Let me remind you, I am saying reminding because this is something you already know. When we perform puja to God, not just to Raghavendra Swami Guru, the Antaryami, Ramachandra Swami, Antaryami, Hanumanta Devaru. How do we perform puja and why do we perform puja? We perform laddu, muruglu, tengulu, what all we enjoy eating, we offer that as naivedyam to God. Does he eat any of that? If he would, some of us wouldn't do naivedyam that generously. Half of it is God accepts, only half will be returned. Oh, every day we wouldn't do, once in a while. On festivals we will do naivedyam because half will be gone. Every day we do naivedyam. And how we do naivedyam? We are guaranteed all of it is returned to us. And we offer what we enjoy most. That's the thing wrong with this. This is how you are supposed to do. Ishtam dharmena yojaye. That is what scriptures say. Ishtam, what you enjoy eating. Of course, shubha items. Na shubham pibati harihi. Dharmena yojaye. You should offer that to God and then eat. Eat that as naivedyam. It is much more delicious. Some of you have experienced. So, even though God doesn't enjoy any of that, we offer food. God doesn't enjoy ornaments. He doesn't need any ornaments. We decorate him with ornaments. Would he like listening to his praise, stuti, stotra? No. It is our expression of gratitude that is stotra. So, likewise, Raghavendra Shripadangalvaru, of course, is a saint. He has renounced all worldly things. But we, having gotten so much from his blessings, in gratitude would like to offer something to him. And what do we offer? We offer what we consider as the best we have. And Suvarna is one of those such things. Gold. We think gold has a very high value. He doesn't care. He has given up all these things. But since we think that is of high value, whatever we think of high value, we give that with great love. We have a small child, 1 year old child, and we adorn the child with golden ornaments. Does the child know? It looks at mother's face. If the mother is angry and putting a gold ornament, it cries. If the mother is smiling when she is adorning with gold ornaments, child is happy. The expression, the devotion, that matters. So when devotees give gold or silver with devotion, as mother expresses her love to the child through decoration of the child, devotees express their gratitude to Raghavendra Swamigalu through dedicating the Suvarna Kavacha. That is the significance of this acharana. I will conclude that there. I will come to the main subject. If any of you are wondering how come Raghavendra Swamigalu has so much power even in Kali Yuga, even in the mid of such a material environment, you know, materialistic environment, people do everything as a show off. There is very little in their antaranga. In such a vishamaya vatavarana, polluted environment, he performs miracles. And I don't have to talk about those miracles. Every one of you, every devotee has experienced those miracles in one or the other form. That is why you are here today. And where from he gets that power? Shri Raghavendra Haripada Kanja Nishevanata Labdha Samasta Sampata. In Guru Stotra, that you do Ashtotra with, Aparnacharya has said it very clearly. Shri Raghavendra Haripada Kanja. Kanja means Kamala. Haripada Kanja Nishevanata Sevanat. By doing the seva of Haripada, Shri Ramachandra Pada, Labdha Samasta Sampat, he gets these powers. Now, Raghavendra Swamigalu himself, in his Pratasankalpa Gadya work, explains how himself and people like him, his masters, like Hanumanta Devaru, Hanuman, those acquire such powers. That secret is revealed in this small booklet by name Pratasankalpa Gadya. Now, last time when I had come, I had given the essence of this in one shloka. Some lady by name Meera Suprao has published that on the web for the benefit of all devotees. Okay, I need to talk to you because there are some mistakes in the script that you have written. People may imitate it wrong, but you have done a marvelous job. Now, that contains the essence of Pratasankalpa Gadya. I have taught that in the last class, in the last time when I visited here. But this time, I am going to take a step further. I am elaborating on that. What Raghavendra Swamigalu has said in Pratasankalpa Gadya. What I chanted in the very beginning is the first line of Pratasankalpa Gadya. How many such lines are there? 29 lines. It is Gadya, prose, not shloka. And are there really 29 lines? No. It is only one line. The entire Pratasankalpa Gadya, 3 pages, is one line. That shows how scholarly he is. Some of you may remember, in olden days, the Hindu newspaper used to have editorial. If it begins from the top, we will see the full point at the end after several lines. Such was the style in those days. Now these days, those people have been very few. Now the style of Raghavendra Swamigala Gadya is so profound. From beginning to end, Pratasankalpa Gadya is one line. And pandits have classified it for the convenience of understanding into 29 lines. And I have uttered first line of that. And maybe today within the given time, I will be able to give the meaning of that only one line. And I will try to explain a little more tomorrow in Somyaji's home. He has a speech in his home tomorrow afternoon, and I will try to explain a little more at their home. Those that are interested may attend the session. What time is it? 11:30? Yeah, 11:30 tomorrow afternoon. Now, what is the speciality of this first verse? It takes you to an unknown world, a world that we have totally forgotten, totally ignored and people that are daring, people that are bold, people that are willing to take bold steps in life can get into this. It is not for all. Sukha dhairya shali. In Raghavendra Stotra, there is an adjective. Sukha dhairya shali. One needs courage to try such things. What is in the first line? There are Ashtamaha mantras. In one line, all Ashtamaha mantras are listed in a single line, that is in the first line that I uttered. Laukika Vaidika Bheda Bhinna Dhvanyatmaka Varnatmaka Asheta Shabdartha Rugadi Sarva Vedartha Vishnu Mantrartha. Now, what are these? It is a loka of mantras. Now, there are two types of devotees: Jnani Galu and Upasakalu. Jnani is who has knowledge. Now, I said there are Ashta mantras in this. And many of us that do Sandhya Vandana and Devar Puja know at least four or five of these Mahamantras. We are Jnanis to some extent. I wouldn't even use that word with full confidence. We know the mantra, we know little bit meaning of that. What are those mantras? Om Pranavopasakanam. Raghavendra Swamigalu says at the end of this first line, Pranavopasakanam. Om is Pranava. Pra prakarshena navati stauti iti Pranava. Pranava is Omkar. Pranava upasakanam. Who are they? Not only Raghavendra Swamigalu. When Raghavendra Swamigalu himself says Pranavopasakanam, he is not talking about himself. Who is he talking about? Pranavopasakanam. Hanumantadev. Vaidev is talking about that. All saints have to do 1000 pranava, omkara japa, a day at the minimum, and 3000 max. So they are all pranavopasakalu. Among them, the pradhana adhikari, the best of all pranava japa mantra upasakas, is Vaidev. Pranavopasakanam asmadadi guru nam. He is guru for all of us. And what are those other mantras that he has listed? He says Ashta Maha mantras. And I said four or five of them we all know that do Sandhya Vandani and Devar Puja. The first one is Om. Without that there is no Gayatri. Om Bhuvah Swaha. Gayatri begins with Omkar. So Om is Pranava, and then Gayatri, Gayatriartha, he says. Okay, and then Purusha Suktartha, the third, who do Deva Puja, they do Abhisheka with Purusha Sukta. Okay, so Purusha Sukta is third. Vishnu Mantrartha, Om Vishnave Namaha, those who do Gayatri, Gayatriyas Trigunam Vishnum, as it says, we have to do three times Vishnu Mantra Japa or Krishna Mantra Japa. Om Shri Krishnaya Namaha or Om Vishnave Namaha. If we do 10 Gayatri, we have to do 30 Vishnu Mantra Japa. Shadakshara Mantra, there are 6 letters. Om Vishnave Namaha. Okay, that is Vishnu Mantra. So, Omkara, Gayatri, Purusha Sukta, Vishnu Mantra. What is there? And then Vyahriti. What is Vyahriti? In Gayatri, there are two parts. Om Bhur Bhuva Swaha, Omkara, leaving aside the Omkara, Bhur Bhuva Swaha is Vyahriti. Om has three syllables. A, U, Ma. And then the expansion of that is Bhur Bhuva Swaha, that is Vyahriti. That itself is a mantra. and then the expansion of that is Gayatri. Tatsavituruvare enyam bharpo devasya dhimahi dhiyoyo na prachodayat. That is Gayatri. So Omkara, Vyakriti, Gayatri, Purusha Sukta, Vishnu Mantra. These are all Mahamantras. Five of Ashta Mahamantras. And then sixth one is Vasudeva Dvadashakshara Mantra. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Those that have listened to Bhagavata, it should remind something to them. What is speciality of Vasudeva Dvadashakshara? The youngest of Upasakas, who got God realization in the shortest duration, he got that realization by upasana of this mantra. That is Vasudeva Dvadashakshara mantra. Who is that Mahanubhava? Dhruva. Exactly. Who is that? My goodness, some kid says Dhruva. Oh, you said Dhruva. Yes. When we hear Vasudeva Dvadashakshara mantra, we should remember Dhruva. A 5-year-old kid did penance for 6 months and God appeared in front of him. And Dhruva wouldn't open his eyes. God had to shake the internal Vasana Pratima little bit. Then God disappeared from his Antaranga, from his Hridaya. Bewildered, Dhruva opens his eyes and he sees that same God in front of him. He doesn't know what to say. God touches the conch to his lip of his, to the tip of his lips, and then there fluently God's stotra comes out. Yonta pravishya mama vacha vimam prajuktam sanjeevayatya kila shakti dharasva dhamna anyamshta hasta charana shravanatva gadin prananamo bhagavate purushaya tubhyam is the incarnation of Dhruvaraya Rama. So, Prahlada Rai, all these Upasakas, that is why I said there are two types. One is Jnani, the other is Upasaka. Those who know these mantras, they are Jnanis. But who are Upasakas? Who implement that knowledge into Japa. As I said, it is a new brave world. Those who do 1000 pranava mantra upasana. Those who do crores and crores of Vasudeva Dvadashakshara mantra. Those who do Gayatri mantra japa and get Siddhi like Gopala Dasaru. They step into a new world that we common people don't hear. We listen to the pravachanas and we do namaskara and we go home and count our money. What do we have for our meals tomorrow? Oh, those are all great things, but this is our life. No, for them, that was life. Labdha, Savasta, Sampata, what kind of Sampata Raghavendra Swami had? This was his Sampata. Ashtamaha Mantras was his Sampata.
What are those Ashtamaha Mantras?
I have just listed them here for your benefit. Some of them I have already said. Pranava, Vyakriti, Narayana Ashtakshara, Om Namo Narayanaya, Vasudeva Dvadashakshara, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Gayatri, there are 24 Aksharas, and then Matrika, very important. See, in the beginning they say, Dhvanyatmaka, Varnatmaka, there are two types of languages. One is Dhvanyatmaka. What is Dhvanyatmaka language? Before, Matrika means Aksharas, alphabet. There are 50 alphabets in Sanskrit. And those, that Sanskrit language that is used in Vedas is called as Vaidika. And Kannada, Tamilu, Telugu, even English, German, all these languages, Prakrita languages that change as time, society, deshakala changes, those are laukika. Vaidika, laukika, bheda, bhinna, varnatmaka, dhvanyatmaka. Varnatmaka means these matrikas from A, A, E, E to H, Kalakshadnya. every letter addresses God. That is the speciality of Sanskrit language. In the world of languages, no other language has this privilege. What does the A means am ajaya namaha, am anandaya namaha, im indraya namaha, im ishanaya namaha, ru rutambharaya namaha, ru, every letter, ham hamsaya namaha, at the end, among the consonants. Every letter addresses God. There is a ekakshara kosha dictionary, Sanskrit. No other language has this kind of dictionary. That is why in the first Gadya he says Matrika Mantrartha. What is Matrika Mantrartha? Matrika means 50 letters in Sanskrit. Matrika Mantrartha Purusha Suktartha, that I have already said, and finally Vishnu Shadakshara. These are the 8 main Ashtamaha Mantras. There is a Tantra Sara Sangraha, where there are 72 important mantras have been listed. Among those, 8 mantras again were picked. Those are called as Ashtamaha Mantras. The meaning of Ashtamaha Mantras is precisely hidden in Omkara, in Pranava. That is why Om Ityekaksharam Brahma, as Bhagavad Gita proclaims, Om means God. What it has? It has the elaborated meaning of all the Ashtamaha Mantras. And keeping that all meaning in mind, Hanumanta Devaru does the Upasana of Sitapate Shri Ramachandra. That is the essence of the first Gadya. Now, I will say one more thing and then I will conclude. The Anusandhana of this, how do we do Anusandhana? I am requesting all of you, the devotees of Raghavendra Swami Gadu, to go to internet and check Pratas Sankalpa Gadya by Madhavacharya. I'm not marketing anybody here, please don't mistake me. I don't know who this gentleman is, but he has done a great seva of Raya. He has beautifully sung the Pratas Sankalpa Gadya. It takes just 12 minutes and 58 seconds. Listen to it as the first thing in the morning. Many of you have an arrangement. You wake up with some music, some news. Put this. Wake up with Pratas Sankalpa Gadya. Listen to it before you become awake. There's nothing wrong in listening to this before you brush, before you wash your mouth, before you wash your face. Our scriptures say, Raghavendra Swami Gadu say, you hear this before you wake up. So make it as an alarm. You have to wake up by listening to this. That is request number one. Every day, listen to this as the first thing when you get up in the morning. Pratas Sankalpa Gadya. Pratah means morning. Sankalpa means commitment. Gadya means prose. You commit to God as the first thing in the morning. That is Pratas Sankalpa Gadya. Even you may not even know the meaning. See, the beauty of this Gadya, Sanskrit language, is many of the words in this Pratas Sankalpa Gadya are there in your native language. Whether you speak Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, whatever language you speak, many of those words are in your language. Because from Sanskrit all these languages have evolved. So you understand the meaning of words as this gentleman utters them. He has rendered so beautifully. So that is number one. Number two, when you pay attention, when you listen to this, it hardly takes 10 to 12 minutes. Pay attention, pay close attention, you understand, and you feel happy. I was so overwhelmed when I listened to this. The devotion in you is really given an expression. So you understand, and the devotion in Rayaru, in Hanuman, is overwhelmed as you listen to this. That is the beauty of this Pratas Sankalpa Gadya. And then the third step, first step is listening, second step paying attention to the words that make sense to you, that are already there in your native language. And the third step, these days Pratas Sankalpa Gadya has been translated to almost all Indian languages. for Kannada readers, I would recommend a book by Davanagere Bhimarayaru. There is a small book you get in Bangalore Vedant Bhavan. It is little complicated. She has elaborated the meaning on the base of scriptures. Those who have some samskara of scriptures, shastras, they enjoy it. Others will benefit little bit. So read it. You will understand more. And then finally, when you meet scholars, ask them questions. Don't let them go. Okay, ask them questions. I have studied this much. I have listened to it. Tell me the meaning of this word. Not much, just one or two words. Every time you come across a Sanskrit scholar, get the meaning of one or two words from Pratasangalpagadhya. I am requesting this so that you can advance in your sadhana. Okay, mere listening to pravachana, mere reading will not do much. I want you all to become sadhakas. And Pratasangalpagadhya gets you into that new realm of sadhakas. I will conclude, my time is over. I will conclude my speech with a song of, not entire song, just one nudi of a great Dasaru that brings out beautifully the essence of Pratasangalpagadhya in their song.
Raghavendra Gurudev Antargat Sitapate Shri Ramachandra Sannidho Samarpitam Astu.